Marquez gets set to start from pole position for a record 64th time. This is the main event of the weekend. 25 laps of this exhilarating Portimao circuit.
More MotoGP than ever before. New stops, new adventures. 21 rounds, 42 races. Can anybody stop Ducati? Green flag waves at the back. We're all set to go here in Portugal in the full length feature race. Bagnaia gets squeezed by both Martin and Marquez, and coming through fast starting is Miguel Oliveira. Marquez was super aggressive on the inside of Oliveira Martin into turn number three. Oliveira though is back at the front.
Bagnaia though does get through at the end of the main straight on Martin.
If you're behind the perfect zero time, eh?
Bagnaia's gone for it into the first gear at the front of this Grand Prix already.
Marquez!
Absolutely slammed into Miguel Oliveira. Yellow flags right in sectors 1 and 2. What a nightmare it's turned out to be for Miguel Oliveira. Gets it all wrong, all wrong. Vinales up into second place. Bezzecchi gets through on Jack Miller, then that's for third place. Somebody has gone down now.
It's Ducati Martin, is it? Zarco now attacks.
This has been a stunning late charge from Johan Zarco. It looks like he might be Ducati versus Ducati. Oh, that was tight. Zarco leans on Alex Marquez, and it looks like Zarco will take the fourth place. But Pecco Bagnaia showing just why he's the reigning world champion. Bagnaia wins the Grand Prix of Portugal. Catches if you can. Good afternoon then, and welcome back to the Termac 3 Hondo circuit for round two.
The rain that's fallen all day, the race is declared wet. Who will conquer the conditions over 25 laps of Termac's?
But on pole position, Alex Marquez on an old Ducati front row. It's time to tango in MotoGP here in Termas. Great launch from pole position by Alex Marquez. Bezzecchi's going to squeeze on the inside of Morbidelli into the first corner. He hits the front of turn one. Brad Binder's gone down. Brad Binder has crashed out. Incredible. Quartararo gets tagged there as well. Zach Nakagami there. As Quartararo, he's been dropped all the way back to 16th place.
Bezzecchi now leads from Marquez and Bagnaia.
Oh, look at that by Zarco on the inside of Rins going through turn number 11. Brilliant stuff here by Zarco. Pressure building. Pressure is really building, isn't it, here from Bagnaia.
Marquez is much more on the limit than Bagnaia, and now he's watching him go past him.
Alex Marquez, though, back through again. He comes through. Bagnaia finds a way back through into turn number 13.
Come down!
Can you believe it? A big, big mistake.
Here's Fabio Quartararo, who's now in eighth place. He's now up behind the fading Alex Rins. As Alex Rins drifts wide, Quartararo now up into seventh place. Zarco once again in the 46s.
Morbidelli was wide. He was on the paintwork there, wasn't he? He couldn't get the power on, and Zarco just eases on through.
Zarco just able to get the power down as he tries to pull alongside Alex Marquez. He'll look to pick up a little bit of slipstream now. He's not even bothering with it, is he? He's up the inside line. He can break so much later than Alex Marquez, who shakes his head. He's got no answer for it.
Absolutely awesome job this by Zarco. It has been a Marco Bezzecchi masterclass here in Argentina. Marco Bezzecchi is the MotoGP winner. Valentino Rossi is a race-winning team owner for the first time in MotoGP. Bagnaia limps home in 16th place. What a day. Brilliant scenes here in Argentina.